So what is going on, guys? NaderBits93 here with another video. And if you guys clicked on this video, then that means you want to get brand new Apple products at a discounted price, right? And I'm not going to go over here and start promoting things like Swappa or eBay or any third party or refurbished seller. This is brand new directly from Apple. So let's get right into this video, because if you guys want to get something like this iPad Pro for $100 off, you're going to want to find out why. But let's get right into the video and I'll show you guys exactly how to get Apple products for the low. Alright guys, so I wanted to show you how to actually access these like discounted Apple prices, right? So the first thing you want to do is obviously go to your web browser. I'm on my iPad, as I always am, guys. And you know, Apple has their normal retail pricing, right? And if you just go in, buy whatever you want. So let's say let's go get a new Mac. Let's go into the Mac section. Let's buy a new MacBook Air. And you guys see that it starts at $1,000, right? The going price is $999. And yes, you can go into the refurb section, and a lot of people have been taking advantage of that, especially nowadays, because it's a lot more prevalent. So you go to the refurbished and clearance, and then this is where all your refurbished goodies sit, right? But the problem with the refurbished aspect is, A, it's still relatively expensive. So you're looking at like a 3-4-year-old iPhone 10 is still $550. And B, the availability is based on how many people just return items, right? And obviously we don't want to rely on people returning items. Like, when I went to go buy my 11-inch iPad Pro from 2018, I had to go every single day to the Apple website, and after about the fifth day, one showed up, and I instantly copped it, and then if I had waited another hour, then it probably would have been gone, right? So that's the refurbished section. What I want to show you guys is the education section. Now, I've been going this route for a while now, and the first time that I did it, I thought, like, you know, it's too good to be true. I need to prove somehow that I'm a student, maybe give them an EDU email or tell them where I'm going to school. And now that you do everything online, because I know in the past when you would go physically into the store, say that you're a student, they would ask for your student email address and then you would get some sort of perk, whether it's like $100 off or a gift card, or they used to throw in Beats headphones. But now, if you go just to the regular Apple homepage, right, and then scroll all the way down here where the refurbished section is, and you just press shop for college, you automatically go into this other store. As you guys can see up here, I'm now in the education store home, right? And everything here is pretty much $100 off. So MacBook Air starting at $899, MacBook Pro, $1,200. Mac Mini is not as expensive. It doesn't get to that $1,000 price point. So instead of that $699 price point, you save $20, right? So most things are $100 cheaper than normal. And as you guys can see, it applies to pretty much everything on here. Right, it applies to all the computing devices. So any Mac, any iPad, and if you guys can see up here, even the XDR, look at that, $400 off the normal retail price, all by just clicking on the bottom link that nobody looks for that isn't marketed by Apple, right? So if you go through the checkout process, this is exactly how I ordered my M1 MacBook Air, which still isn't here sadly, but as you can see, $899 instead of that normal $999 price point. And not only that, but I also traded in my old MacBook Air, so I'm only paying $200 for this MacBook Air. And as you guys can see, there's nothing that makes you prove that you're a student or you're in the education sector or you're a teacher or a professor. So it's kind of just like a discounted bypass way of buying Apple products. Now, it doesn't work for accessories. It doesn't work for little things. Most of these items are, you know, plus $500. I think the cheapest item that they have here is the 10.2-inch iPad, which if you go down, you can see that you actually only save $20 on this iPad. You save $50 on the iPad Air. And then for the iPad Pro, you also save $50. And you can see the iPad Mini, also $20. So pretty much depending on which avenue you go, I would say from $500 to $800, you save $50. Anything below $500, you save $20. And anything above $1,000, you save anywhere from $100 to $500, depending on how much you decide to spend, right? And even, let's see if you can buy the HomePod for a discounted price. So as you guys can see, no real discount on the HomePod, but you can see that we save a lot of money through the education store just purely through the Apple website. And these are all brand new products, so you're not dealing with a refurbished product. You get the brand new packaging just as if it's a brand new product. And look, these are the latest and greatest MacBook Airs, MacBook Pros with the M1 chip, you have the iMac, even the Mac Pro. As you can see, you save $400 off the starting price for the Mac Pro. Now, the one thing that I do want to check with you guys live, which I actually didn't check before this video, was to see if, you know, any upgrades are cheaper, right? So if I go into the upgrade, you do save a little bit of money on each upgrade. So if I wanted to go 16 gigabytes, you save $20. It used to be $200, here it's $180. Same thing here. So you basically save about 10% on each single upgrade, right? And you guys can see how the numbers play out. So normally 2 terabytes of storage costs you $800. 10% of that is $80. So it brings you down to $720. So that's the beautiful thing with this website and with this portal inside of Apple's website. Everything is just cheaper because it's assuming that you're in the education. So, I mean, hopefully Apple doesn't block this by me putting this out there. I doubt anybody's gonna actually see this, but this is a little bypass that I've been doing for a couple years now. I bought my iPad Pro this way. Like I told you, I got the MacBook Air that's on the way in this exact same way. And the previous MacBook Air that I currently own, I actually got a Best Buy for full price, which was a big mistake, guys. But let's get out of this view and go to the normal view. So as you guys saw, these products are all brand new from Apple, and you're just in the education section. Maybe it's just a weird bypass for now, but I've been using this way of actually purchasing Apple products for about 2 years now, and I haven't seen anything change. Normally, you used to go into the store, like I mentioned before, and prove that you were a student, prove that you were a professor or a teacher, and then they would give you the discounted prices. But I guess now that everything's online and they want to keep everything as efficient as possible, they just created this education section. So I highly recommend going that route, especially if you want to get a brand new product, because everything for the most part is $100 or $50 off, right? Except for the, like I said, the Mac Mini, and even the upgrades are discounted. That's how I purchased the new MacBook Air M1 that's still on its way, and that's how, you know, I plan on purchasing the rest of my stuff. And the return policy is exactly the same, right? So if you guys want to try something out for a little bit cheaper, try it for 14 days and then return it. And that's also an option within Apple's purchasing arena and purchasing portal, right? So being able to get all these products at that discounted price, brand new from Apple, is just a huge thing that I wanted to share with you guys. And hopefully, you know, I don't think anybody from Apple's gonna see this, but hopefully they don't kind of change that up and ruin it for everybody. But highly recommend trying it out, especially if you guys are trying to save a little bit of money during the holidays. But that's gonna do it for this video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Till next time.